How's it going, everybody? Coach Dan here at Own Plot of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and today in this Essentials of Self-Defense video series, we're going to go over escaping inferior positions. So we're going to go over three major positions in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu: the side mount, the mount, and the back mount. So I'm going to start with Mario here on top of me in the side mount position to start off. In this position, he's off to a 90-degree angle from me. His knee is nice and tight to my hip, so that I can't slide my legs in place. He's isolated my upper body, and he can hold me down here, almost like he's pinning me in wrestling. He's really holding me in position. So now that I'm in this position, I want to make sure that my forearms are underneath him. My arms are out here. All I can do is pull. I want to be able to create space and push. So my hands are on the inside, one under the neck, one at the hip. This foot, my right foot in this case, is going to brace out. So it comes in close to my hip and it braces out. And now I'm gonna shoot my hips through Mario's elbow out in this direction. So I cut my left hip underneath my right and I move out like so. Now I'm gonna push with my arms, extending my upper body away from him, sliding my legs in place, and we return to the guard. Where now I can go over attacks, I can go for chokes, or I can just work to escape. Once we're here, back again at side mount. Once more through, I'm in this position. It's important to note that right now my knee cannot get inside to get to guard. It can't, it's just not possible. Once I turn to my side, watch this, my left knee's gonna slip in automatically. Right here. As soon as I cut that hip out, that space opens up. This space down here opens right up. So, swinging through. My forearm's still underneath the throat, bracing away. And once I get him in guard, I can pull him into close guard. Now he can't really strike me as effectively because I'm pulling him down. I can start to set up my own attacks. Second escape from this position is the underhook escape. So again, I'm here with Mario. Now instead of trying to move my hips away to get back to guard, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna still cut my left hip under my right, but I'm gonna do it more so still at this 90 degree difference from Mario. So I'm here, brace, and as I brace off him and I bump in towards my side, my right elbow, you'll notice, will go underneath his armpit. I'm gonna explain why, here. As I do that, I bump, my elbow kind of makes a little small circle and tucks itself under his shoulder. Now that I'm here, I extend with my arm, I reach across Mario's back, I pull with my top leg, and I flare my right elbow. So my right hand is stuck on his back, I flare my right elbow, pull myself out from underneath him, grab the waist, turn to my own base here, now I come up to control. Whether I'm striking, whether I can work chokes, or whether I can just escape the position as a whole. So I'm here once again, down in position, Mario's on top, gripping. I cut and just get onto my side, weaving my elbow underneath. Dip, cut to my base. If he overhooks, I can limp arm, cut back through, control position. That's the underhook escape. Now let's say we're in mount. So Mario's got the mount position on me. Here, obviously, a lot more threatening in terms of strikes, a position I do not want to stay in for more than a matter of seconds. When I'm here, I want to have one hand up to defend strikes and also to be able to brace Mario away if need be. My other elbow is going to go on the inside of his knee. I turn to the side, whatever side the elbow's on the inside of the knee up. Now, I step over Mario's foot, so I take my high side leg, my right leg is on the ground, my left leg is a high side leg, I step it over, I curl his foot over mine. Now I'm gonna push down on his knee with my forearm as I drive my knee above his. I need to make sure my knee gets higher than his, and now I can swing my hips like a hammock. So I cut them out and I swing them back to face Mario. Boom, stay on top. As I turn the back and face Mario, now I'm back in a half guard position where I have him between one of my legs. If I really want to be able to defend myself here, generally, I'm going to go back to a full guard. Now again, I can tie him back up and start to work my own attacks. Once again, from the mount, Mario's here. As I make my turn, elbow dips in, step, curl it over, drive his knee down lower than mine. Not still on my knee, it's down below my knee. I swing my hips out, put back in to face Mario. Escape away, feet on the hips, or close guard. And I come into control my position. The last position, and at least in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, but certainly probably in self-defense situations as well, the worst position is the back mount. It's where Mario will have both of his heels on the inside of my legs, one arm over at my neck. Generally speaking, in this position, my best escape is going to be to get my back to the mat. If my back is on the mat, that means his chest cannot be on my back. That means he cannot probably choke me, at least not in the same way he can here, where if this forearm gets under the throat, it's gonna be bad times. Yep, boom. So, from this position, preferably, I always wanna, although I can escape the same escape on this side, I preferably wanna go to the non-choking side. So whatever side is underneath my arm, I turn to that side. I get my hips to face the ceiling, and as you'll see, that will get rid of this bottom hook of his.
hips face the ceiling. If I can't shake the bottom hook just by turning my hips to the ceiling, what I'll do is I'll stomp his bottom hook out with my top leg. Stomp. Cut my leg over. My hips now face the ceiling. I'm going to take my right elbow. I want to cut it between us. So I want it to separate us. And as I do that, I'm going to shrimp and I'm going to move my hips out in this direction. Almost like we did from side mount. That same kind of hip movement. Out here. I control over Mario's leg. I turn myself up the top. I can flatten him out, control position, or I can just get up and escape.
So that's that, guys. Three primary inferior positions in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and how to escape them.